So now let's move to keyframing, and I am going to show you what it is, what it's used for, where to find it, and how to use keyframe to create seamless animation. So, first, what are keyframes? A keyframe is a marker used in animation and video editing to define the starting and ending points of an effect or motion. It helps create smooth transitions and animations by setting specific values at different points in time. And in CapCut, keyframes can be identified by their diamond shape on most of the editing features you can use in your editing project. And every editing feature that has this diamond beside it means you can create an animation using keyframes on that feature. So, let's create a practical example for you to understand keyframing. So I am going to create a zoom in text effect. So first go to text and let's add a default text to the timeline. So, I will type fusion here. Then change the font also. So, I will scale it down a bit. Now place the playhead to where you want the animation to start from. So I want mine to start from the beginning. Then under basic scroll to transform. Then I will add my first keyframe on scale. Then move the playhead to where you want the animation to end. So I will move the playhead to the end to the text. Then I will scale my text to be a lot bigger. And CapCut will automatically add a keyframe at that particular place for you. And this will create a text zoom in effect using keyframes. And with keyframes you can move them and position them at where you want. So, if you want the animation to be fast, move the keyframes close to each other. And if you want the animation to be slow, you move the keyframes away from each other. So, let's go deep into keyframe animation in CapCut PC. So I am going to show you how you can control the speed and smoothness of animations by adjusting the easing between keyframes. This helps create more natural motion effects instead of robotic transitions. So, I will right-click on the text, then click on Hide Variable Speed Animation, and the speed animation will pop up. Now select any of the keyframes, so I will select the second keyframe. And if you come to this side, you will see these small icons here. The first one is the preset curve, and it contains varieties of already built-in keyframe speed animations for you to use. Some examples are ease in, which the speed of the animation starts slow, then speeds up, ease out, which the speed of the animation starts fast, then slows down. So, there are a lot of preset curves you can try here. And if you don't want to use the preset curves, I will show you how to create your own. The second is linear. The default motion is linear, meaning the animation moves at a constant speed. Then third is the auto curve, and when you click on auto curve, CapCut will create its own speed curve for you. The fourth is one of my favorite, free curve, and with this you can adjust the speed to how you want it. So, click on it, then you can use this bar to create the speed animation you want by dragging it to anywhere that you want. But I strongly recommend that use the preset curve to make things a lot easier for you. So in the next section, I am going to show you 10 amazing effects you can create using keyframes in CapCut PC. So if you have any question, drop it in the comments section, and also subscribe and give us a like. See you in the next tutorial.